someone who likes me for me, not some notion who they think I am.
Girls just don't speak to me. I don't get it.
I try to make an effort. I really do.
Someone told me once I'm intimidating, but I'm not. I'm actually really lonely.
People take one look at me and judge me.
No one understands. I'm just me. I'm a really decent person. People would see that if they just gave me a chance. Just give me a chance. See me. I'm right here.
On the day that I found out my dad had left, I went to school because I didn't want to be at home without him. How could he not love us enough to want to live with us anymore? It was too real at home. Mum was a mess. She'd kicked him out when they had a fight. She thought he'd come back. He'd always come back before, but this time he didn't. School felt more normal. I was upset for a really long time. My friends didn't know what to say. At first it was hugs and ohs and poor yous and I know how you feel. Because you know, everyone's parents break up. And for most people it doesn't really seem like a big deal. But it really affected me. I just couldn't get over it. I felt like something I loved was broken and there was no way I could fix it. And I felt like a freak because I kept bursting into tears in class. And at first people felt sorry for me, but then they just started avoiding me. But there was this one girl. She was a new girl in year 10. I don't even remember her name now. She knew. She helped me. Even if it was just to listen when I was sad, which was a lot of the time. And after a while, I guess I just became okay again. I'm in a good place now. A really good place. That broken little girl feels like she has the world at her feet now. All of this though, everything in my life is all thanks to that one girl whose name I don't remember. You know, I don't even recall her being there at the time. She must have moved schools again or something. It's funny. She'll never realize how much she helped me just by listening. And I'll probably never be able to tell her. I wish I had.
know.
Yeah, right, it's so obvious.
So, what if she does?
Girls, what have I told you?
Sorry, Mrs. Spencer.
Because here's the snowball shot of hell of him ever liking her back.
Can you imagine? It would never, ever happen.
He's got standards. He wouldn't even look at somebody like you.
You're just jealous because he dumped you, Mia.
Shut up. That's not what happened.
I know exactly what happened. 3 weeks ago, you guys were besties, and now you've unfriended her on everything and are trying to make her life hell. All because she likes the same guy as you.
Keep out of it, Nikki. It's nothing to do with you.
I don't like him.
And why does it say it on this letter?
Oh. How did you get that?
Dear Lucas, this is a letter I will never send because it tells the truth about how I feel about you.
Girl, sit down.
Give that back to me.
Give it back.
Lucas, I can't stop thinking about you. I go to bed thinking of you. I wake up thinking of you. You're in my dreams.
What was that, your nightmare?
Stop, please. I just stop. Wish you could see me for who I truly am.
No, Michael, give that paper to me.
Oh, just one last step. I actually think I love you!
No.
So sweet.
Mia, this behaviour's completely unacceptable. You've got to listen to instructions in the future. Now, if I have a peep out of you lot again...
Sorry, Mrs. Spencer.
Right, everyone just go on with your work.
What's her problem?
My brother Jack had just left high school. We were really close, and I thought he was the coolest person I'd ever met. He was always so fun and happy, but one year before Christmas, he seemed really down. I thought he was just feeling a bit overwhelmed about having to finish high school, applying for uni and everything, but one afternoon, I saw him on the kitchen table, crying. I was shocked. He always seemed so brave and strong. He told me he was gay, and that he'd come out to a few close friends who were all really friendly and supportive, but now he was panicked, because he had to find a way to tell me, and Mum and Dad. I admit, I was shocked at first. I just didn't know what to believe. He had girlfriends, plenty of them, and I'd always imagined that one day he'd come home with this beautiful girl, and we'd be best friends, and I'd be a bridesmaid at their wedding. Stupid year 8 stuff, you know. Anyways, he seemed so relieved to tell me, and I was so happy that he had. He still wasn't ready to tell Mum and Dad, though. He knew he had to tell them. And one night, after dinner, he just blurted it out. I'm gay. Mum was quiet for a really long time. Then she started to cry and said,
"You're my son. And I love you no matter what."
My dad, he didn't say anything. And then just said,
I don't understand it. I don't think I ever will. It makes me uncomfortable.
My brother tried to encourage him to educate himself more, to see that being gay isn't a choice.
It's just the way I am.
The way I've always been. But no. My dad just got up and left my brother there, crying. We tried to go back to normal after that, pretending Jack's love life didn't exist. Then he moved to Sydney. He hasn't been back once. We've been to visit him a couple of times, and he takes down those photos of that boyfriend and pretends they haven't been dating for nearly 3 years. Well, they're happy, really happy. My brother hopes that one day my dad will understand. I hope so much he will too. You see, my dad's a really smart guy, but I just don't think he really tries. The truth is, I miss my brother. I really do. He's the best person I know.
Thank you.
because I've never been kissed. I'm 16 years old and I haven't even come close. Every single one of my friends has been kissed, except me. It's embarrassing. I mean, until last Saturday night, it was both me and Bex that hadn't been kissed, so it was okay. But then, at Amory's sweet 16, she hooked up with Daniel McPherson. That was quick.
Did you kiss him?
Yeah. Oh my god. He's so hot.
I know, right?
How was it?
Well, it was good. Kind of got what I was expecting or hoping for.
What?
Oh no.
It was kind of wet and quite so slimy. His tongue had a mind of his own. It was like he was trying to eat my face off.
What? Oh no.
He also been eating something weird, like gum leaves or something.
What? Gum leaves?
Why?
Either that or like a whole pack of really strong gum. It was like passion of koala.
Maybe he thought your tongue was a gum leaf.
Maybe he just wanted to have mint fresh breath.
Eucalyptus.
Well, at least I've got it over and done with.
My first kiss was with Dwayne, you know.
We know.
It was wonderful. I was totally in love with him at the time. It was perfect. He was such a good kisser. Then he went off with Gloria.
Ah, Gloria. Again.
Then I didn't love him. Then I just wanted to rip
him. We know, sweetie.
The day I turned 11 was the worst day of my life. It started out really well. Mum woke me up early so we could have a birthday cake together. Pancakes. Dad was away at work, so we Skyped him. I was pretty upset that he couldn't come home for my birthday. And on the way to school, Mum and I got into a really dumb argument about it. When I went to get out of the car, she tried to give me a hug, but I told her, I'm too old for it. And pushed her away. I guess I was just upset that she would try and defend him, or probably embarrassed at who might see us. As I slammed the door, she said,
Please, Alice, it's your birthday.
I didn't even turn around. I just walked away. That was the biggest regret of my life. At lunch, my friends and I put all of our food together to make a birthday picnic on the oval. The kids playing footy got so mad and started kicking balls at us, but we just laughed and didn't budge. Then Mr. Jones turned up. He said,
I need to take you to the office.
At first we thought it was really weird and that maybe it was the year fours that had told us to ruin their game. But then he said,
I only need you.
We all laughed and thought it was weird that he didn't just wait until I got back to class. But then I saw Mr. Jones's face. Will was joking that I'd done something really bad. Mr. Jones told them to stay, but they followed anyway. Cameron and Michael laughing the whole way, teasing me that I was going to be suspended or something. Ange didn't. She saw Mr. Jones's face too, and held my hand the whole way there. I asked, can they come to the office with me too? Mr. Jones said,
no.
When I got into the office, my dad was there, and some other teachers, I don't even know who. Dad was crying. I knew as soon as I saw him something had happened to Mum. He couldn't even look at me. He just looked down and kept on crying. His whole body was shaking, and he was making these really weird little hiccuping noises, and I almost laughed. Can you believe that? I knew what was about to happen, and I almost laughed. I knew. Someone told me to sit down, and then someone said it. Not my dad, he couldn't. But someone said the words, and then my whole world went black. And a part of me died too. When they took me outside to go home, they were all waiting, my friends. The bell had gone ages ago, but they refused to move. They knew something had happened, something bad, and they wanted to be there for me. And that's how it was from then on. Through all the really bad times, they were there. They made me feel like I still had a family, even though mine had been ripped apart. They cared. They care. Even though we were separate because of high school, I knew they would always be there for me, and I for them.
Always.
Jumpy and anxious over the littlest things. Everything scared me. I didn't want to leave my mum's side, and I didn't want to go back to school. Just the thought of it made me feel sick to my stomach. Mum would always try to make me go. This would turn into a huge argument where I would start crying, my chest would feel tighter and tighter, and I'd slip into a full-blown panic attack. This happened almost every day. Eventually, I did go back to school. I wanted to be normal so badly. This didn't stop my panic attacks, though. My friends would always say to me, just calm down, don't worry about it. That's easy for them to say. They don't know what it's like. I've managed to come up with some ways of tackling my anxiety, but every day is still a battle. I hope that one day soon, I can start to feel normal again. But what is normal anyway?
Are you? Yes? Good. Because then he wrote,
We should totally catch up and watch a movie or something. I know, Pete McIntyre asking me to hang out and watch a movie with him in a dark cinema where he could totally, like, kiss me or something. Anyway, I'm not trying not to get too excited because this is Pete McIntyre. So I, like, waited for a whole minute, which was torture, but I didn't want to seem too keen. So I, like, waited for 65 agonising seconds, and then I just wrote, sure. So all casual, when I felt like screaming, yes, 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 I'll have your babies, Pete McIntyre. So anyway, this is the part I need your advice on, because it gets really, really complicated. So he wrote, I can ask Stephen to come, and you can ask Stace. Boo! Double date! Hard to get a pass when your besties are in tow, but I'm thinking at least I'll be on a date with Pete McIntyre. But then I thought, does he mean a double date as in like him and me and Stephen and Stacey? Or a double date of Stephen and me and him and Stacey? Does he like Stacey? Or what, he's never met Stacey? Or has he? Are they secretly dating? I mean, she would have told me, right? She tells me everything. But then, why would he call her Stace if they've never even met? Stace is a nickname, and you only give people nicknames when you like them personally or generally know them as friends. Oh, do you think he secretly likes her and Stacey just hasn't told me because she knows I'm madly in love with him and have been for months? Then it gets really, really complicated because he said, thanks, Jeannie, I love you. What the actual I love you? Spelt like L-O-V-E, not just L-U-V. That means something, right? I mean, it's gotta mean something. And this refers to the R-U reference from earlier. If he's the sort of guy to use letter abbreviations when texting like R-U, why would he use the actual word love if he didn't actually love me? Like, for real? But then he put one laughing and crying, one laughing crying emoji, and one love heart emoji. Does the laughing crying emoji cancel out for the love emoji? Or is it the other way around? Oh, I don't know what to think about any of this. I'm so confused.
I just want someone who likes me for me. Not some notion of who they think I am. Girls just don't speak to me. I don't get it. I try to make an effort. I really do. Someone told me once I'm intimidating, but I'm not. I'm actually really lonely. People take one look at me and judge me. No one understands.